Good morning to everybody. So we are doing the exercise 1.1. That first part is every natural number is a whole number. Look at the fourth question. First part, every natural number is a whole number. State whether the following statements are true or false. That first part, it's true. Because every natural number is a whole number. Because natural number starts from what? 1, 2, 3. Am I right here? Then whole numbers, it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 and goes on. So that every natural number belongs to the whole number. But converse part is not true. Please remember here, because every whole number is not a natural number. Because 0 does not belong to the natural number. Am I right here? Every natural number is a whole number. But every whole number is not a natural number. Now, come to the second point now. That second question it is, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. Now tell me, whether it is true or false. Every integer is a whole number. Yes, tell me dear. Now, integer means what? Set of all positive numbers, negative numbers, including 0. Set of all positive numbers, negative numbers, including 0, are called as what? Integers. Here every integer is a whole number. No, that every positive integer is a whole number, 0 is a whole number, but negative integer does not belong to the whole number. Therefore, it is false. It is false because minus 3 and minus 2, right? These and all does not belongs to the whole number. Does not belongs to the whole number. Am I right? It is an integer. Minus 3, minus 2 is an integer. But it is not a whole number. Are you getting there? But converse part is true. Every whole number is an integer. Every whole number is an integer. Are you getting there? Yes. Now, come to the third part now. That third part is every rational number is a whole number. 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 Subdivision 3. Every rational number is a whole number. It is also a false. Every rational number is a whole number. We know that every whole number is a rational, but every whole number is not a rational number. Alright, for example, you can take like it's false because you can take like 2 by 3 here. It is a rational number, but 2 by 3 is not a whole number. It is not a whole number. Are you getting dear? Every whole number is a rational, but every rational is not a whole number. Now, come to the fourth part now. Anything is given? Only 3 parts were given, am I right? Yes. Now, after that, exercise 1.2 we will do later on. Before that, I want to give some introduction part. Decimal expansion of rational number and irrational number. Decimal expansion of rational number and irrational number. What is mean by irrational number? A number which cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, where q not equal to 0, both q, p and q are integers. Irrational number. Irrational numbers are denoted by q bar. Irrational numbers are denoted by q bar. Now, come to this one. The decimal expansion of a rational number may be terminating. The decimal expansion of a rational number is either terminating or non-terminating. If it is non-terminating, it should be repeating. In where? In rational number. Are you getting here? The decimal expansion of rational number may be either terminating or non-terminating. If it is non-terminating, it should be repeating. What is meant by terminating? Yes. It has the ending point. It has the ending point. It will end somewhere here. It will end somewhere. Non-terminating means it keeps on going. It keeps on going. Repeating. It keeps on going. At the same time, certain number of digits repeats again and again. I will give you an example for that. See. 1.32323232 and goes on. It is not terminating. Keeps on going. At the same time, which one is repeating? 32 is repeating again and again. Are you getting here? So 0.853853853 and goes on. It is non-terminating. It is non-terminating. At the same time, it is repeating. Which one is repeating? 853853853 is repeating again and again. So this 1.323232 can be written as 1.32 bar. That meaning is after decimal 32 occurs again and again. That means repeating. Which one is repeating? 32 is repeating again and again. 0.853853853 and goes on. What is the meaning of that? 0.85 after decimal, that is 853 is repeating again and again. Are you getting there? Yes, repeating. Repeating means what? After decimal point, certain number of digits will repeat again and again. Terminating. Terminating means what? It is an end point. It is an end point. Now, for example, 3.852, 4.753470. I'm right here. Otherwise, 7.001238. Am I right? 9.123512543217. Okay, you don't bother about the number of digits after decimal point, but it is a terminating decimal. It is a terminating decimal. Are you getting there? So the decimal expansion of rational number is either terminating or non-terminating. If it is non-terminating, but it should be repeating. Then what can you say about the decimal expansion of irrational numbers, sir? Decimal expansion of irrational number. The decimal expansion of irrational number is always, please remember, always non-terminating and non-repeating. What is meant by non-terminating and non-repeating? Non-terminating means what? It has no end points. It has no end points. That we know that. Am I right here? Non-terminating and non-repeating. Non-terminating and non-repeating. For example, 0.01001001000001 and goes on. That means what? Here after decimal, it keeps on going. That's what it is, non-terminating. Here none of the digits is repeating again and again. Here it is what? See, look at this digit. 01. After that 001. And then 0001. Then 00001 and goes on. Are you getting here? Now see. 8.1234. 12345. 12346. 12347. And goes on. Here after decimal, none of the digit is repeating and again and again. Am I right, sir? 8.1234, then 12345, 12346 and goes on. So therefore, the decimal expansion of irrational number is always non-terminating and non-repeating. Are you getting here? Please remember, you have to keep only three things in your mind. What is that? If it is a rational number, then decimal expansion will be either terminating or non-terminating. If it is non-terminating, it should be repeating. It should be repeating. The decimal expansion of irrational number is always non-terminating
and non-repeating. Right? If it is terminating, then you can conclude, yes, it is a rational. If it is non-terminating, then only you have to think whether it is repeating or non-repeating. If it is repeating, then it is a rational. If it is non-repeating, then it is an irrational number. That's all. Only three things you have to keep in your mind. Are you getting there? Yes. In the next video, we will solve one or two questions. Am I right? Okay. Thank you, dear.